tough act to follow. As many of you know, we have a long-standing relationship with ophthalmology because almost everyone in my family, including the person right behind you, is visually challenged. And I think I got my first pair of glasses, I was about 10, 7, maybe smaller, okay. So the ophthalmology department was quite small then. It was, I knew Dr. Hawam, Samir, Salamon, Camille Matta, and I think one more. So it was a very interesting time because it's a very talented department in which everyone had a busy practice and yet was still interested in research. And that says something about Dr. Hawam because he is a son of both of the great traditional academic institutions, and not just academic medical institutions, that probably underpin much of the culture of this nation, which are AUB and St. Joseph's University, where he got his medical training, really the two institutions that for more than 130 years have produced probably 80% of the new knowledge, a disproportionate number of the students, and candidly, much of the culture, certainly the academic culture of this country. And that's why I thought it was a perfect jumping off point. Dr. Hawam was born in Hazin, a fundamental town to this nation, which now looks to us in the academic world as it struggles with next steps. What does Lebanon do next? What does the Middle East do next in order to find our way out of the current interesting predicament we find? And we talk to the students. The discussions are always interesting. They can be contentious. But we started talking to them in early September about the importance of role modeling. And I want to reflect on that for a minute. I found it very interesting that you chose Nelson Mandela, because that's really, in many ways, for current people of our generation, the ultimate role model. In fact, I was at a ceremony two and a half years ago with the leader of the Palestinian secular movement, Mustafa Barghouti, not his cousin Marwan, who's in prison. And he was feted as the Arab Gandhi. And I took him aside afterwards and I said, you know, my hope for you is that you are the Arab Mandela, because he got to grow old and make an impact and then still enjoy several generations. And so that's one of the things that we're happy to wish for Dr. Hawam. You're a role model, but you don't have to be sacrificed on the pillar of your integrity. You can enjoy the generations of superb ophthalmologists that have succeeded you. And I have to say, it was my pleasure and privilege to review for the dean and for the AUB Medical Center, the Department of Ophthalmology. It was an interesting review because the day when I came for the initial discussions was the day that President Obama indicated that he would potentially bomb our neighbor Syria. So I think Baha was kind of surprised to see me coming to meet him in his office. And we conducted really a review that showed that this is a role model department, Dr. Hawam, a department that you can be proud of, a department where collegiality, research, teaching, enterprise, patient care are all on display, with a wonderful sense of individuals whose destiny is a common one and whose belief in the importance of that mission is shared. So from that perspective, you've left a tremendous legacy of mentorship. And that's what we want today. That's what we talk to our students about. We talk to them about taking important risks for good reasons and not being afraid to fail, but moving things forward in the right direction. From that perspective, you have been an ambassador for AUB for close to six decades and hopefully many more, but an ambassador who, like Nelson Mandela, was on the ground and impactful. Also talk to them about scholarship. What's the importance of scholarship? The importance of scholarship is not just to innovate and not just to teach, but to learn. If you look at the great researchers and the great academicians, they're individuals who are always perpetual students. I remember being seven and seeing the innate curiosity on the second floor of the Diana Tamam Microsoft Law Building that inflicted, from an infectious perspective, everyone from Samir Akhri as a medical student, all the way to Suhail Jabbour and to my late father. So that idea that the scholar is perpetually curious, that the scholar is always interested, and you've shown quite impressive evidence by publishing continuously. I went on online. You've published articles in each of 5 decades, and if that's not a commitment to scholarship, I'm not sure that is. So you've covered the mentorship aspect, you've covered the scholarship aspect. So that leaves the service aspect, because if you think of the underpinnings of great academic institutions, and as I've said to the students, to our faculty, to our staff, AUB is great, but it should be greater. You have served generation after generation after generation of patients, of students, and of colleagues, and you've never shied away from responsibility. So for that aspect also, you are a role model. So from my perspective, with what you have done in your career, and I think it's safe to say from your colleagues in the Department of Ophthalmology, you embody the core values of AUB, the core values of your other alma mater, Saint-Joseph, whose president I had the privilege of having breakfast with a few weeks ago, and even more than that, the core values of this region, which continues to introduce individuals who are undeterred by the odds. The odds against you as a son of Lazier, being in Baltimore, being in San Francisco, going all over the world to come back and to constantly improve, would have been daunting. But you were not deterred by the odds. And for that, and for so much more, we thank you for all you've done for AUB and all you'll continue to do for AUB. Thank you very much.